Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Pratik Nagavde. Welcome all of you to certificate course in soft skill training program organized by Sri Anand College Bathurdi. Hope all of you are safe at your home. Today's topic under the program is time management. So let's begin. We all have 24 hours a day, neither less nor more. Whether we succeed or fail, it depends on how we use these 24 hours. But we don't know how to make the most of our time, where to save it, and how to make our life meaningful. That is why it is important to recognize the principle of the best use of time. Time management is one of the key factors to success in any field of work. It is important for your personal life and for your career. Time management teaches you patience and how to tackle difficult tasks in a given space of time. So we can say that time management is life management. Therefore, you should try to understand different attributes of time. The first and the foremost important attribute of time is its neutral nature, meaning that everyone gets the same amount of time. Second important aspect of time is a finite nature, meaning that it cannot be reduced or increased at any cost. Also, it cannot be saved for future use. If you lose money, you might get a chance to make it back, but a wasted hour is irreplaceable. Therefore, we can say that it has a value currency. So let's learn the definition of time management skills. Basically, it is nothing but managing ourselves in relation to time, which include setting our priorities and proper utilization of time to achieve maximum quality output. By sharpening and practicing time management skills, you can expect to be more confident and effective at work. Let us know something more about what are time management skills. Time management skills include a variety of skills that will help you to manage your time well. Some of the most important time management skills are organization, setting priority, goal setting, communication, planning, delegation, and stress management. Let us know all these skills. Organization is nothing but staying well organized, and it can help you to maintain a clear picture of what you need to complete and when. Setting priorities. Assessing each of your responsibility for priority key in being a good time manager. There are many ways to prioritize what you need to accomplish, which we will see in coming. Goal setting. Setting goal is the first step to becoming a good time manager. Goal setting allows you to clearly understand your end goal and what exactly you need to prioritize to accomplish it. Setting both short and long term goal can lead to success in your career. The next skill is communication. Developing strong communication skills can allow you to make your plans and goals clear to people you work with. Another important aspect is planning. A fundamental part of time management is planning. Being efficient in planning out your day will help you stick to your schedule. Delegation. While it can often be difficult to say no when someone asks you to do something at work, it is important to practice having boundaries to manage your time well and ultimately accomplish your goals. Stress management. When practicing good time management, you should also be attentive to your mental health. Handling stress in a positive way can help you stay motivated and perform well when going through your schedule. Taking time to develop each of these skills will help you organize your daily work and to attain your goal. Let's see the benefits of time management. First benefit is stress relief. Making and following a task schedule reduces anxiety. As you check off items on your to-do list, you can see that you are making tangible progress. This helps you avoid feeling stressed out with worry about whether you are getting things done. Second benefit is more time. So good time management gives you extra time to spend in your daily life. People who can manage time effectively enjoy having more time to spend on hobbies or other personal pursuits. The third important benefit of time management is getting more opportunity and less time wasted on trivial activities. Let's also consider the consequences of poor time management. First one is poor workflow. The inability to plan ahead and stick to goals means poor efficiency. If you don't plan ahead, you could end up having to jump back and forth or backwards in doing your work. That translates to reduce efficiency and lower productivity. Second one is wasted time. Poor time management results in wasted time. For example, by talking to a friend on social media while doing an assignment, you are distracting yourself in time. Third one is loss of control. By not knowing what the next task is, you suffer from loss of control of your life. That can contribute to higher stress levels and anxiety. Also, another disadvantage is poor quality of work. Poor time management typically makes the quality of your work suffer. For example, having to rush to complete tasks at the last minute usually compromises quality. After considering the benefits and drawbacks of time management, let's look at some ways to manage time effectively. First thing is set goals. Set goals that are achievable and measurable. Use the SMART method when setting goals. Make sure that goals you set are specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and timely. Second, prioritize wisely, the most important aspect of time management. Prioritize tasks based on importance and urgency. For example, look at your daily tasks and determine which are like important and urgent. Do this task right away. Secondly, important but not urgent. Decide when to do this task. Third, urgent but not important. Delete these tasks if possible. Not urgent and not important. Set these aside to do later. Set a limit to complete a task. Setting time constraint for making tasks help you be more focused and efficient. Making the small extra effort to decide now how much time you need to allot for each task can also help you recognize potential problems before they arise. Fourth point is take a break between tasks. When doing a lot of tasks without break, it is harder to stay focused and motivated. Allow some downtime between tasks to clear your head and refresh yourself. Considering grabbing a brief nap, going for a short walk, or meditation. Fifth point is organize yourself. Utilize your calendar for more long-term time management. Write down the deadlines for tasks that are part of completing the overall project. Think about which days might be best to dedicate to specific tasks. Sixth point is remove non-essential tasks or activity. It is important to remove excess activities or tasks. Determine what is significant and what deserves your time. Removing non-essential tasks or activities frees up more of your time to be spent on genuinely important thing. And the last and the most important point is plan ahead. Make sure you start every day with a clear idea of what you need to do, what needs to get done that day. Consider making it a habit to, at the end of each workday, go ahead and write out your to-do list for the next workday. That way, you can hit the ground running the next morning. These are some important thumb rules to plan your day. First one, always visualize your long-term goal to achieve it. Try to follow your plan every day. In the initial phase, it will be difficult. But as you practice it more, most importantly, write out a to-do list every day. Don't jam your day full of activity. This can be achieved by having a wise plan as discussed earlier. Most difficult part or step of time management is do it now or it's never. Don't forget to plan time for family, fitness, recreation, social and spiritual. Hope you have understood the importance of time management and its skills. So use this lockdown period to set your goal for next semester, prepare an action plan for it, act on it, and achieve your goal. For now, stay home, stay safe, and follow the rules. All the best. Thank you.